welcome to Economic Heartbeat of Rialto. I'm here today with one of our local business vendors, and I'm really happy to introduce the community to Mr. Roy Martinez and his son, Anthony Martinez, and they are Welders Arc Rentals, and they are a business that's been in our community. And I just want to thank you guys for joining us today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
One of the things about our community is we're really growing. We have over 2,200 business licenses in our community and new businesses coming every day. So I would like you to just tell us a little bit about your business again. And I don't know if I got the name correctly.
No,
so, you know, Welders Arc Rentals.
Yeah, Welders Arc Rentals, we established it in 2008. Mm-hmm. It's a family-run business. We specialize in welding and safety supplies, also industrial supplies, and we rent welding equipment.
Okay.
And also industrial equipment, light towers, golf carts, etc. We started it to bring back the customer service that has been lost over these, you know, nowadays.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
And we started with one welder in my father's garage.
Yeah, that's what he was mentioning.
And now we have over 100 pieces of machinery.
Fantastic.
So it's going well.
Wow, fantastic. Well, it must be a testament to your skills and talents. Didn't burn down the garage, did you?
No, I didn't. Got closed.
As you said, you started in the garage and found yourself with a number of things, equipments and things that you were renting. And what caused you to move out of the garage and expand?
We were growing, so you know, we needed to get out of there and get our own shop, and because we were growing at a kind of a fast pace, but we had to slow it down.
Mm-hmm.
But the demand was so great, you know, that we just kept growing and growing, and we just kept turning it, you know, the profits and buying new equipment, you know,
mm-hmm.
till where we had finally get our own shop, and we did that, and we grew out of that, and we came back home. Yeah, with Rialto, so, you know, we want to stay here now and help the community.
Good, you know. Great, thank you. Yes, that's what you were saying earlier, that your business grew, and so you were over, yes. You were in Riverside originally, and,
yes.
And you've been now. And where are you located? What's the address?
We are at 1111 West Rialto Avenue.
Okay.
Right across the street from the Rialto Middle School.
Okay.
Just about on the corner of Cedar and Rialto Avenue.
And hours of operation?
We are actually open 24 hours a day, mm-hmm. 7 days a week available to our customers.
Well, that's good.
If we're barbecuing or something like that and you call us, you need a machine, I just get one of my boys on the grill and go take care of it.
Oh, great. So. Great. Well, you mentioned bringing back customer service, and I
yes.
think, you know, that's good because there's a balance right now with a lot of services are always online. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you miss the human, you know, that contact in the customer service. So that's really good. I know that you needed a little help along the way. How did you get started, or did you just build it as kind of as a part-time activity? Or
No, this is something that we knew that we wanted to do. He has over 30 years experience in the rental industry. And ever since I started working, we've always worked together. And like you said, you know, everything's very, there's no feeling.
Mm-hmm.
There's no feeling like you're going to, personal touch on anybody you talk to anymore. And we wanted to bring that back. It mm-hmm. was, as far as like who influenced us and stuff like that, I think I would say each other.
Good.
We really push each other, and family is something that's very important to us. Community is very important to us, and giving back is very important to us.
Well, you mentioned giving back, and I'm gonna give you an opportunity to give a shout out because you told me you graduated from one of our high schools.
Yes,
so.
Rialto High School, class of 97.
All right. And so in giving back, participate with activities in the school district high school?
That's one of the reasons why since we've been back, we're trying to get established with the city and everything like that to be involved in the community.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, we do light towers for Bloomington Christian,
mm-hmm.
and
okay.
I also announce the varsity football games.
At Bloomington?
Yeah, we do a lot of stuff for them, donate a lot of stuff. Azusa Pacific, Susan G. Komen.
Okay, good.
We do a lot of stuff with MS and autism too.
So what do you think was that, what was the smartest business decision you think you made?
Hiring me.
Hiring you. Smartest business decision.
I'm just kidding.
No, I would say smartest thing we did was when we purchased our machines, not get excited and get it way out of hand, you know, get way ahead of ourselves and just take little steps at a time to grow. And we just kept reinvesting in the company, just turning it over and over to keep buying everything. And so now, at this point, everything we own, everything that we have, we own. We, you know, it's all ours, so, you know.
That's good. So you don't have to invest, you don't have to keep adding the costs associated with getting building up the inventory, but then you still have to bring in new and recycle out or depreciate out.
And that really is a testament to his discipline, because there have been plenty of opportunities for us to take 4 or 5 steps forward, which probably would have extended us in the beginning. And for him to slow it down enough where we grew and we're comfortable with every step that we grew.
Yes.
So that really is, you know, his philosophy and something that we continue on a daily basis to this day to do business that way.
Now you mentioned, you know, even if you're barbecuing and somebody needs something, you stop and you can get, how many employees are you, do you have on site?
Well, on site, basically we have 2 girls in our accounting department and it's me and him.
Oh, okay.
And we do have help. Like if we have 4 or 5 deliveries going on and from Indio to LA to San Diego, you know, we have people that we can call to come in and help us.
Wow, that's broad territory.
Yes.
Yeah, so you're covering all of San Bernardino County and San Diego County?
San Diego Riverside. County, LA County, Riverside County.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, we do work with big contractors like Clark McCarthy, LAX, LA Air Force Base.
Wow.
Huge places.
SpaceX Universal Studios, Fox Universal Studios.
Yep, all the studios.
See? You know, we have, and that's what's interesting about Rialto, and this is one of the reasons I enjoy taking the time to talk with our businesses, because sometimes I find that the things that we're doing in Rialto reach beyond the San Bernardino County, Southern California. I mean, they're providing resources and services or products all throughout the United States, and it sounds like Your ability to provide equipment and rental goes beyond even beyond Southern California.
Yeah, well, actually, it's one time we sent equipment to
Florida
for a couple months. One of our customers was going down there to do I believe it was a Benihana, and he needed equipment to take with him, and we worked it out and was able to ship everything down there for him.
So that's been your furthest point?
So far.
You're open to all possibilities, right?
Yes, always.
Okay, well, you know, in Rialto, we really try to pride ourselves on being business friendly. We're really trying to make sure that it's not just lip service, but actually that we assist our businesses. And so could you tell us if anything, there's been any advantages for you as far as your ability since you've come back to Rialto?
Well, actually, first and foremost, we would like to thank you and also Barbara for helping us out, because since we've been dealing with the city, since we've been working with the city, it's been nothing but open arms.
Thank you.
Nothing. We've felt welcomed since the very beginning.
Well, thank you.
And
on behalf of the city and behalf of I won't take the credit, because it's really our employees and our units, our departments that really, they work to make it happen. But I think they definitely get a feel for, you know, the things we need to do and what we want to accomplish in Rialto. So I really appreciate that.
Yeah,
it's unsolicited. But we won't have to, you know, we'll give you $5 later or something. Okay. What are some of the opportunities you see for yourself here in Rialto?
Well, I know
and your business.
I know we want to be more involved in the community. We were just discussing earlier too about opportunities to put on vendor shows and maybe earthquake prevention shows, Just whatever the community calls out for, we would love to be involved in. Mm-hmm. We love to support the police department, the fire department. We always feel the need to give back. Mm-hmm. So the more involved we can get with the community in whatever aspect, we would love to do it.
Okay. And not only that, we would we'd like to help a lot of people who don't have jobs that come in. We can teach them a trade, mm-hmm. you know, and help them along wherever we can. You know, and that's one of our goals that we kind of like to keep set, you know, because mm-hmm. we helped a lot of people make, form their companies, and now they're loyal, they're bigger than us, and they're loyal to us as far as material, rentals, and everything, mm-hmm. you know, so we like doing that.
You know, I appreciate that, because sometimes just having an opportunity for someone to even have a place where they can go and get some hands-on training. You know, I speak to young adults all the time, and I just was speaking with one yesterday. Sometimes non-paid experience and the training you get for going and volunteering can help you out. It can really help launch, you know, the information or the knowledge you need to display on a resume. It doesn't always have to be a paid job or a paid experience. So I'm glad to know that you're open to that.
Yeah, and we do know a lot of schools, mm-hmm. and they'd be more than willing. We've sent plenty of people over there, mm-hmm. for people to learn a new trade, mm-hmm. and it's limitless on what we would be willing to do.
Great. Well, we're going to take a moment, pause, as they say, for the cause, and I'm going to be right back with Economic Heartbeat of Rialto.
I lost my brother Frank in the Battle of Iwo Jima.
He served on 4 combat tours
in Vietnam,
in Iraq, in Afghanistan. There's a life that was lost behind that pin.
I put it on for my wife,
for my husband,
my brother,
my dad,
my son.
We wear it because we honor those that we lost.
To learn more about the stories behind the Gold Star pins, visit goldstarpins.org.
Returning to Economic Heartbeat of Rialto. And again, I'm here with Anthony and Roy Martinez of Welders Arc Rentals. And we've been having a great conversation. Yes. And so, you know, before we conclude, I wanted you to speak a little bit about the family. Dad and I were talking about the grandchildren, but I know that there's other members of the family. So why don't you
My brother, who lives in Rialto, also graduated from Rialto High School. He has 2 daughters, and he's actually the one that when I told you there are people that we can call on to help us out and stuff, mm-hmm. He's one of the ones that come and do it. And also his wife also helps us out.
Truly family-owned, operated business.
Yes, good. Yes, we like to keep it that way. And my mom, who's been in the school district for 33 years.
All
she started off as a noon duty aide when I was, you know, in elementary, and now she works at the
food service kitchen
mm-hmm, mm-hmm. in Rialto. And she survived breast cancer, and now she has it again.
Oh.
And she's actually our hero.
Mm-hmm. And backbone.
The backbone of the family. Yeah, she actually keeps us strong.
But she's in treatment and doing
She's doing good. She's in good spirits. She's still got her sense of humor. Mm-hmm. She's probably the funniest one out of all of them.
Yeah. Strong.
Yeah, strong woman. We love her.
That's fantastic. Yeah. That's also the support when you mentioned the Susan G. Coleman.
We've done walks for Susan G. Coleman, support, constant support. And that's where, you know, that's where our heart is, mm-hmm. and whatever we can do to help.
Well, you know, this, we also have here in the community the Relay for Life, and we have the annual walk. So hopefully, you know,
absolutely,
we will see you there.
Yes.
And matter of fact, we'll say a prayer. We know we'll see her there.
Yeah.
Yep.
Okay, in that walk. You know, business always has challenges. And you and I were talking briefly about the challenge. What do you see is probably going to be your challenge? Sounds like you keep holding it back, but.
Yeah, my challenge is that to keep holding it back because it wants to jump out and just jump five steps ahead of us. And in order for us to control it, you know, and keep in business, we take baby steps. And mm-hmm. we observe it we study it every 6 months, and if we need to grow bigger, then we'll grow bigger again. You know, we come up with growing pains about every 6 months, and you know, and that's our greatest challenge, to keep it simple too.
So do you feel like your current location is going to be able to accommodate the growth in your expansion? We won't lose you, will we?
No, you're not going to lose. We're going to expand bigger. We're going to be opening up a few more stores, you know, but our main office is going to stay here. We plan on getting a big warehouse and things like that, you know, to bring everything in.
We actually plan on purchasing property.
Yep.
Now, you know, we're renting a warehouse and stuff, but we plan on purchasing property here in Rialto, mm-hmm. and just expanding here. This is home.
Well, you know, our economic development department, we work hand in hand with business on finding them some space and location. So we'll be happy to do whatever we can to make sure we can find some space that allows for your growth. And I think I heard another thing that I really like. Sounds like you might even consider franchising or moving yourself out or adding additional sites, and then Rialto would become corporate office.
Yep,
huh?
Yep. Yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
Corporate office in Rialto.
We actually have opportunities already to grow in the Lake Elsinore and Temecula area.
All right.
But like we said, corporate and home will always
be here.
Okay.
And then as we wrap this up, you know, we have clearly in Rialto, we're a community, as you know, of very young people, a lot of young adults. Then we have a good blend, a good balance, I say, young and seniors. But what would you say to the young adults who are trying to figure out which direction they should go and how they should pursue their career goals?
Well, I would say, when we were talking about it earlier, you know, everybody has million-dollar ideas.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody's got a million-dollar idea.
Mm-hmm.
Be brave enough to take that first step forward. And when you get there, the one thing that he's always taught us and instilled in us is don't ever let anybody discourage you.
Right.
Ever.
Right.
You know, just take that first step forward, and the next thing you know, you're three steps forward, and that first step is
behind you.
Mm,
fantastic. That's a great philosophy, Dad, to pass
Thanks.
On.
Thanks. Well, we stick to it real hard, you know, mm-hmm. and most time what we see and what I see, you know, is a lot of people get discouraged because doors shut.
Yes.
You know, and they don't realize that nothing's easy. You just got to keep going for it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and that's what I can only tell people is that, hey, just keep going. Don't let people turn you away or tell you something different.
Mm-hmm.
Use that energy for positive and go after your, you know, what you want in life.
Yeah, people really need to remember that sometimes when one door closes, another door opens.
Yes.
And I don't think we often remember that or recognize that.
You know, there's one philosophy I like to say too, is that I always told my boys when they're growing up, the sky's the limit. So,
mm-hmm.
you know, you make it what it is,
mm-hmm.
you know, and they still keep that.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, it's been a pleasure.
Yes.
Sitting here talking with you, and you know, I'm excited about the possibility. Anything we can do to help kick off the vendor fair, help to find the land that you may need, that you want to purchase, so you can grow.
Yeah.
You know, just don't hesitate to call upon us.
Absolutely.
You know, and so this will conclude our conversation with Mr. Martinez and his son Anthony, Roy and Martinez. I would really recommend that if you're looking at things you need to rent, or if you're looking for some welding assistance and respirators, or if you perhaps is looking for a good barbecue.
Yeah, there you go.
Why don't you stop by
right.
Welders Arc Rentals. They're located on Rialto Avenue, just across from Rialto Middle School.
Yes.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you.
It's been
a pleasure.
And that will conclude this segment of Economic Heartbeat of Rialto.